Is there a motion to approve a bid for Crown Power on the purchase of a one-wheeled loader for a net cost of $84,985?
So moved. Second.
We are scheduled to replace a 1999 case articulated wheel loader in this budget year. We advertised for bids. We received, surprisingly, 7 bids. The low bid with trade-in is from Crown Power for a Case 621E model loader. The next low bid was for a JCB brand loader. It is staff's recommendation that we purchase the loader with the lowest current cost after trade-in, which would be the case. There are some additional savings possible because we already have a case loader, which will be traded in, but any special tools in some parts will still be the case. We budgeted $120,000 for this. The low bid after the trade-in is $84,980. We have a guaranteed buyback associated with this for 5 years, but in today's economic times, we anticipate that we will probably keep this unit longer than 5 years. The Basin CNF sewer project started in late spring. It is now substantially complete. In fact, most of the work on this project was finished before the end of the year. This is what is in effect the final change order to make adjustments from contract quantities to those actually installed after they were measured in the field. It also makes adjustment for a couple of changes to the project which had to be made. One is the realignment of the sewer and the addition of 2 manholes on what's called Site 41. This is just off of First Street. And between the times the plans were drawn, there were some improvements done by a private property owner right adjacent to the easement. It was physically impossible to lay the sewer on the alignment that was designed without endangering the foundation of that home. So we realigned this sewer. Additionally, the original plans called for replacing a sewer that ran from 4th Street to the helipad in the parking lot at Northeast Regional Medical Center. Runs in what had been the alley behind the Ray Cancer Center. Upon further evaluation, it wasn't necessary to tear up that whole parking lot. We essentially abandoned a manhole and 300 feet of sewer that had nothing connected to it. Set a new manhole and then line the remainder to minimize the impact on that property and the overall cost of the project. So that changed quantities. We also added a sewer over parallel to La Harpe, between La Harpe and Shelby Street, to try and resolve the leaking situation there. The bottom line is that change order 4, the total adjustments is $20,209, making all adjustments for this entire project $50,079.72, and the final contract price will be $847,493.22. This is an increase of 6.28% over the original contract. Since this was a repair and replace with a great many unknowns and contingencies when we started, to finish this project at just over 6% is, in my opinion, very good. So I ask your approval of this change order, and we'll go ahead and get this contract closed out.
John, just a question. How did the home get built? over something that...
It wasn't built over the easement. It was built immediately adjoining it. The problem is that it is only a 10... The sewer from the sewer line to the home is only 10 feet. It's 15 feet deep. In order to dig deep enough to get to the sewer line, we would endanger the foundation of the home.
Is there any way that could be prevented in the future?
In all honesty, in these older situations, no. We should have recognized that there was a problem with the alignment when the plans were drawn and moved it at the time the contract was bid.
For existing easements, we're going to find those problems here and there. But for new water sewer lines, we have better capabilities of knowing where they're located, having them in, within the middle of the easement or whatever, taking those things into account. Is that not
That's correct.
Okay, that's what I was concerned about.
But when we get into even some of these older areas of town, we're kind of at the mercy of the records. Sure. And
well, we're actually at the mercy of the backhoe. When you dig the hole, you find out where it really is.
And that is true. That is true.
I was just concerned about new construction. Yeah. So that
and by doing this, then we basically have a new clean easement without the danger of somebody infringing on it.
Okay. Thank you, John. Any other questions? Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Is there a motion to approve the reappointment of Mary Mayhemmer to the Highway 63 Transportation Corporation?
Second.
Council's just being asked to reappoint me. Just so you know, at this point of the Highway 63 Corporation's life, the major decisions have already been made. We are pretty much just doing housekeeping, making sure that tracking the revenues, that payments are made, and that MoDOT is continuing to fulfill its obligation.
Any questions? All those in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Vicki.
An ordinance authorizing the mayor to execute a contract between the City of Kirksville, Missouri and the Missouri Highway and Transportation Commission for air service promotion at the Kirksville Regional Airport. An ordinance to allow the City of Kirksville to participate in the annual Missouri Show Me Green sales tax holiday. An ordinance of the City of Kirksville, Missouri approving a lot split land which is part of Block 1 of the rededicated Sunset Village addition to the City of Kirksville, Adair County, State of Missouri, which is on or near 2910 North Baltimore Street, and an ordinance of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, granting a special use permit to Capital Towers 2 Limited on real estate described herein.
Is there a motion to approve these bills?
Yes, again. So
second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Are there any council comments?
I have a comment. Just want to remind you that you have a special council meeting tomorrow at 3:30 here. And I think you have one council candidate in the office, or in the room, Sandy Slocum,
yes.
Right? Okay. I don't think there's any others.
I didn't say any others.
I just wanted to encourage everybody to check out the new city website that went up on Friday, and give us your feedback. Right, Sheree?
That's right.
Good job.
City staff has done an excellent job on the website for the city. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Glad to see those trucks out, John. With the snow.
He's glad to hear that you noticed that the trucks were out.
Okay. Is there a motion for adjournment?
I so move.
I second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Our next Kirksville City Council broadcast will be of the February 2nd, 2009 meeting. Thanks for joining us and have a great evening.